Hey guys, it's Courtney, and today we are going to be taking a look at the new mini ergonomic blending brush by Pink and Main. Now, here is the regular size one, and this one has been out for a little bit of time now. You guys have probably at least heard of it. You may have not had a chance to try it, but you can see that it comes in kind of like this case where it just slides in and out, and it protects your bristles. And the mini one, which you can see is still in its packaging, so you're going to see me use this for the very first time today, is packaged exactly the same. It's just in a mini version. So you have that little packaging or that little holder kind of to protect your bristles while you're not using it. It's so, so soft. I love these brushes, but you can kind of see the size difference here. And the thing that I like about these brushes is that it's got the handles and you hold it similar to a traditional ink blending tool like the Ranger ink blending tools that we all started with, but you have the blending ability that you do with your makeup brushes or your other blending brushes because you actually have the bristles. So I think, in my opinion, that they blend very nicely, but they're just a little bit easier to control and easier to hold. So if you do have issues with your hand, whether it be arthritis or just if you do a lot of things with your hand and your hand cramps up, this is nice. It's very easy to hold and very easy to use. So today we are going to be making three very simple ink blended backgrounds with these brushes today to kind of try these out. And I've never tried the regular size one either, so this is new to me as well. So for the first one, I'm just going to be doing regular old ink blending, and I'm going to use Distress Oxides, which in my opinion are the easiest inks to blend. So I'm going to use the mini one, and I'm going to be using four different colors. I'm going to be using Carved Pumpkin, Picked Raspberry, Seedless Preserves, and Dusty Concord. And this is one of my favorite combinations anyway. So if you guys have ever watched one of my videos, you'll notice that when I do my ink blending, I like to start from the top or from one particular area, work my way down with all of the colors that I plan on using, and then I'll work in the opposite direction. And the first time around, I'm kind of just laying down my color. And then when I work back up, that's when I'll actually concentrate on my inks blending together. The first time around, I'm not worried about it. I'm just placing the inks down. Now you can see that I'm getting some blotchy areas, and that's just because I'm going in with a very light hand. I don't want to add too much ink to the paper the first time around, because once you add too much ink, especially with the Distress Oxides, they kind of lay on top of the paper. You're not going to be able to move them around. So I like to add just a little bit of ink at a time. So I've reached the Dusty Concord. Now I'm going to go in the opposite direction, add that Seedless Preserves, and make sure that Seedless Preserves blends with the Dusty Concord. Then I'll bring in the Picked Raspberry, and you'll see that I'm using the same brush the entire time. I'm just kind of wiping it off on my scrap piece of paper. I didn't have any kind of contamination at all. Very easy to clean. So I'm going to finish off with the Carved Pumpkin here on the top, and realized I just didn't have enough orange, so I ended up bringing that down a little bit further than I had the first time. That's what's good about kind of laying down your color and then going back over it, is that you can kind of change your mind. So to finish off this panel, I'm going to take some shimmer spray and just spatter that on the background, and I'll just take a paper towel just to dab that up. This will leave behind the shimmer but not make your paper too saturated. So I actually made two very simple cards with this particular panel. For the first card, I just basically cut it. That's all I really did. But I used the Hello die, also by Pink and Main. And for the first one, I just kind of added a strip, matted that onto some black cardstock, and added my sentiment with black and white cardstock. Finished it off with a few glitter drops. Is that what they're called? Nouveau glitter drops. Yeah, that's what they're called. And for the second one, I just simply added that strip across a landscape card and did a little bit more ink blending for the actual Hello die, just so it matches my background. So for the next panel, we are going to bring out a very intricate stencil. I want to see how well this gets into those little tiny spaces. So I'm bringing out this stencil by Neat and Tangled, which is the most intricate one that I have in my stash. I did spray this with some Pixie spray before laying it down onto my card panel because, like I said, it is very intricate, and you'll see in a minute that I still had some issues even after using the Pixie spray. Now, I'm also going to bring out some Simon Says Stamp dye inks, which are, I can't say they don't blend, but they're not actually made to blend. They're not my first choice when it comes to ink blending, but I wanted to see how well they did perform with these brushes on top of an intricate stencil. So you can see I'm using 5 different colors here, and I'm going to start off with this Wisteria ink, which is purple, and I'm going to start with the upper left-hand corner. Now here I'm going to go in with a really light hand. These inks are not, the colors that I chose aren't super dark, but they're pretty vibrant. More vibrant than my background will be. I wanted more of a soft background. So I'm just going to go in with a really light hand. And you'll notice as I work my way down to the lower right-hand corner that they really blended nicely. Of course, I did choose colors that will blend nicely, but this ink is not made for blending. And once I remove the stencil, you'll see that it did get into all of those intricate areas. I had no issue with the stencil at all. And this is where my stencil starts to shift a little bit. Apparently, I just didn't spray enough of that Pixie spray on the back of it. I tried to hold it down, it wasn't working. So I ended up having to add just a little bit more of that Pixie spray. And because I have so much of it blended already, I had no issues kind of lining it back up to where it belongs to finish off my ink blending. You'll see here that I did not go in both directions. So like the first panel, I worked my way down and then worked my way back up. For this one, I didn't, because I'm going in with such a light hand, and with the brushes especially, you can control how much ink is on the paper a little bit easier than a regular ink blending tool. So I'm able to achieve that really soft look in the background. So here I can go ahead and remove the stencil and see that I have a perfect coverage with this mini ink blending tool. Now for this card, all I did was did the same thing for the sentiment itself. I did some ink blending, then cut out the hello with the same colors I used for the background. The shadow piece is just some white cardstock. And because I used some waterproof ink, the Simon Says Stamp dye inks, I ended up adding some glossy accents, which is hard to see on camera, just to the word. And this makes it shiny and stands out a little bit more from the background. I cut my background panel with a stitched rectangle die. So for the third and final panel, I am going to be using some of the Ink on 3. I'm going to butcher this name. Atelier inks. Just because I wanted to use different inks to see how well these performed. So I'm going to use a stencil for this one as well. But first, I'm going to add just a little bit of color to my background. So you can see that these colors are really bright and vibrant as well. And I switched over to the regular size ink blending tool. And I'm just going in with a super light hand. I am tapping off a little bit onto my scrap paper before bringing it to my card panel. But you can see that you can get such a soft look. And in person, it's hard to see on camera, but in person, this is just absolutely beautiful. It gives such beautiful pastel colors, regardless of what kind of ink you're using. So I like the fact that I have a little bit more control with the pressure that I'm adding. You still have control with a regular makeup brush or ink blending brush, but for these, I find that I was able to control the amount of ink a little bit easier, and maybe that's just because of that ergonomic handle that we have on top. So I'm finishing off with the blue and the purple there on the bottom, and you can see that it is very light. I did go a little heavy-handed with the blue, but that was my own fault, and my ink pads are very, very inky. So I just wanted to add a little bit of color to the background before I did my ink blending over my stencil. So I'm going to use another Neat and Tangled stencil, and this time I'm not going to bother to use the Pixie spray because this one has a lot of solid spaces to it. So I'm just going to take a little bit of Post-it note tape to tape down all 4 sides to the back portion of my stencil. So I'm taping the back of the card panel to the back of the stencil just to make sure it doesn't shift around when I do the rest of my ink blending. So now I'm going to go in with a heavier hand. I'm going to bring back out my mini ink blending tool, and I'm going to not tap off so much on my scrap paper. And I'm going in with just a little bit heavier of a hand, and I'm going over the same area where I added the initial color. So basically where the blank spaces would normally be, or white spaces would normally be, I'm going to have just a little bit of a hint of that color behind it, but it's going to be really nice and vibrant where I went over it the second time. So again, I'm just using the same brush over and over, just kind of scribbling it off on my scrap piece of paper, and I did not have any problem with these contaminating either. So for this final one, I went ahead and cut this down with a stitched rectangle die and layered that onto a black piece of cardstock, added my sentiment again. This time I skipped the shadow and just added a little bit of glossy accents to the word die and finished off with a few black Nuvo drops just to add a little bit of something to the background. But that is it. Four simple cards. Love, love, love these brushes. So I will link all of the supplies in the description box below. These brushes are now available as of today in the Pink and Main store. So I hope this was helpful, especially to those of you who have issues with your hands and have issues with ink blending. These will be a lifesaver. Have a great day, guys. Bye.